beats in your face. I want to introduce you to a concept called Triple A. Who's heard of Triple A? Who besides the people I know, who's in Triple A? Besides the people I know. Put your hands up. Okay, cool. So some of you have heard of it, but you're not in it. Okay, so I'm going to reveal the facts and the truth. Are you open-minded? Cool. So we found a way that we can grow our money by 30% per month. Who's excited to hear more about that? So what is Triple M? Triple M is like a stock belt. So what is a stock belt? So let's say everybody in the room gets together and they give money to this gentleman this month. Call it 500 rand. Everybody gives 500 rand to this gentleman up here. Next month, everybody gives 500 rand to, let's say, Kim. Okay, and then next month, everybody gives 500 rand to me, and I'm definitely running away with your money. So sometimes that's how stock bell works, okay? You've got to be very careful of who you introduce into your stock bell. It's got to be like friends, relatives. You can't just have a stranger in there because you're definitely going to lose your money. So we in a stock bell, your money doesn't grow, okay? It's like a forced savings account. Is that correct? Okay, so in our stock bell, we've managed to find a way that we can earn 30% per month on our stock bell. So it's basically the largest exchange donations network in the world, with over 200 million members in 118 countries, and we get rewarded for helping the community. That's all that it is. So how did it start? So can I tell you the good, bad, and the ugly? Because it's lots of ugly. I know you've heard, haven't you? Right? Okay, cool. So in 1989, there was a gentleman by the name of Sergei Mavrodi. He was Russian. He went to the government to ask for a new listing of shares, and the government didn't want to give him the shares. And the reason they didn't want to give him more shares is because he became very, very powerful, and Russia being a communist country the way it was, they didn't want anybody to become powerful because then they could literally overthrow the government, and it was a threat to the government. So they called it tax evasion, and they basically sentenced Sergei Mavrodi to prison. Before they did that, when they said it was tax evasion, they fined him $50 billion. So when he got the debt, he immediately wrote a check for $50 billion that cleared, but the government still wasn't interested in that. So they sentenced him to prison, and he served several years. While he was in prison, the public voted Sergei into the Duma, which is basically their parliament. So he became like a minister. And the reason that happened is because when the government shut Triple M down, the government stole the money. There was a proper paper trail, everything was audited, but the government wasn't interested in that. They stole the public's money. So you can imagine how disgruntled the public became, so much so that they got together and they voted Sergei Mavrodi into parliament because they wanted him to be released from jail, because they wanted him to continue with his mission, which was to create a fair financial order to help people. So Triple M went through various different platforms over the years, and we're now left with the platform that works. In 2011, it was launched in its digital state, which is what you're experiencing today, which is very exciting. So our ideology, the MMM, the members of MMM, our philosophies and our ideologies, is that we believe that the banking system is a very corrupt, fraudulent, selfish system that only benefits a few people. It basically benefits the bankers. That's all that it benefits. So maybe you want a loan, you got a good job, I hope, and you go to the bank and you want to like better your life, you want to like get more, I don't know, stuff in your home, stuff in your life. You go to the bank, let's say a loan for 100,000 Rand, you go and apply, the bank says, sorry, you don't qualify for the loan. So they say, go back and fill in these forms and get these documents and do this to your documents and then come back and resubmit. Has this ever happened to anyone? Yes? So you basically, they're teaching you how to crook the books. Okay, that's what they've done. So you go back, you submit your documents, and then they press a button on the computer, bing, the 100,000 Rand is in your bank account. You see, what you need to be asking yourselves is, where did the 100,000 Rand come from? Have you ever asked yourself where it comes from? You see, that's where the problem is. You see, the banks print money. They print it illegally. It's a fact. This is not my theory. If you go onto YouTube, you can go on Google or go on YouTube, all this information, and go and see exactly and verify these facts. So if you had to print money, that would be counterfeit. You go to jail. But if the banks do it, it's legal. Okay, so they give you this money because they want to enslave you, because they know that you're not going to be able to pay this loan back. You see, that when you get the loan, in 3, 4, 5 months, maybe a year, you know what's going to happen? You get the big R. It's called retrenchment. Okay? Recession. Are you getting richer or are you getting poorer? Just checking. Okay, things are going up. And you know why there's inflation? Because there is an excess of money. Because your money has no value. Okay? Previously, money was backed by gold. That's what gave it its intrinsic value. In the 70s, they removed the gold standard from money, which means that the money that's in your pocket is just a piece of paper with pretty pictures and a number. It's perceived value. Okay? So when you print money, there's inflation. You can hear it on the news. Have you heard this stuff before? Okay? So they print this money legally, they give it to you, you end up in trouble, okay? You can't pay your debts. The bank, unfortunately for you, isn't interested. They still want their money, okay? So you become literally a financial slave forever. There's nobody in the room like that, I'm sure. We're all flush. Yes? Yes. So what we want to do is we want to crush the current financial system. We call it the financial apocalypse. And what we want to do is we want to empower the masses to live like the few rich. And who are the few rich? The bankers. Do they work harder than you? No. Okay? We work hard. We should also live like them. And that's what we want to do to somebody. Okay, so if you had R1 million and you were a multi-millionaire, okay, would you donate that money? Is it legal to donate money? Okay, cool. So that's exactly what we do. We're just a bunch of people that donate money to each other. It's a peer-to-peer system, which means that we donate money to each other. There's no central bank account. MMM is not a business. It's not a business. There's no CEO. There's no... it's not an investment, okay? It's just, it's like Facebook. It's a platform, a digital platform. It's, what does Facebook do? Facebook does what? Connect people, connect friends. And that's exactly what Triple M is. It's a digital platform that connects people, a person that wants to donate money with a person that wants to receive a donation. That's basically the crux of Triple M. So how does it work? There's a couple, the opportunity is one to donate money, which we call provide help, or PH, okay, and two is to get a donation, which we call get help, or GH. Those are the only two terms you really have to worry about in Triple M. So this is your website. When you join tonight, you're going to get your own website, and as you can see, there's two buttons here, a provide help button and a get help button. So let's say you had 10,000 Rand extra money. Extra money in Xhosa, Swahili, and Zulu means extra money. That's the direct translation, okay? It's not money that you're going to use for your car, not money you're going to use for your rent, okay? It's not money that you're going to say, oh, I'm getting my salary in 3 weeks, let me PH the money, I'll get my salary and then I'll pay. No, no, no. That's called greed, okay? You wait for your money. After your bills are paid, whatever left, okay, you use that money to donate. Does it make sense? Are we on the same page? Are you with me? Are we together? Cool. So you've got 10,000 Rand, you go to your website, you hit the provide help button, okay? You haven't paid anybody, it's basically just a pledge, a promise to pay, it's a promissory note. In X amount of days, I promise to pay a person, okay? Within 30 days, 7 days, whoops, between 7 days and 30 days, you'll be asked to pay someone. So on your website, it will tell you exactly who you need to pay. You'll pay that person directly, okay? You'll go to the bank and you'll do an internet transfer or cash deposit or whatever you do. They'll give you the deposit slip. You'll take the deposit slip and you'll upload the deposit slip into the Triple M system. Okay? Once you've done that, your side of the transaction is complete. Okay? When you've done that, you will then wait 30 days or 60 days, whatever you prefer. Okay, at the moment you have to wait 60 days. So your money's going to grow 30% 1 month, 30% the next month, which means that you've almost doubled your money within 60 days. Okay? Then you're able to get help to the value of your Mavro. So when you PH, what happens is that when you hit the provide help button, your 10,000 Rand is converted to Mavro. Mavro is the Triple M currency, basically. Okay? So it's basically a reward. It's saying thank you for helping the community. You can then get help to the value of your initial donation plus the growth in your Mavro. In this case, it would have been sitting for about 2 months. You're going to
you're going to get up 19,000 rand. Are you excited? Doesn't seem like it. You see, do you guys want to learn how to print money like the banks? Do you want to learn how to print money? I've just shown you how to print money and print money legally. Not illegally, legally. You should be, if you're not excited at this point, I think you better check your pulse because you're probably dead. Are you alive?
Yes.
Hello. Cool. So the rules are only use extra money. You can only have one website per person. Okay? Use your own bank account. You can't have a shared bank account. So if you're living together as a couple in a home and you have one bank account that you share, go and open your own bank account so that you conform with the rules and regulations. If you're a husband and wife couple? Yes. No. Any husband and wife couples in the room? Okay, we're trying to train a community of honest people. That's what we're trying to do here. So there's no guarantees, which I have to say that there's no guarantee. There are guarantees. Two guarantees in life. Death and taxes. Okay, those are your two guarantees. Okay? So read the terms and conditions. The terms and conditions state, use extra money. Do we understand that part? Cool. So, can it fail? Let's talk about the guarantees. Well, anything can fail. Does a business need customers? So if there are no customers in a business, can a business survive? Not really, right? Unless you've got, unless you're the trust fund baby and have got unlimited funds. Anybody in the room like that? Because I need a loan. Eh? No one? Okay, cool. So can it fail? So this is what we call a healthy cash flow system in any business, including the Triple M platform. This is the amount of money that's coming into the system. This is the amount of money coming out of the system. Okay, obviously, for any system to survive, there has to be more money coming in than more going out, a positive cash flow. Does that make sense? Okay, so that's what we have at the moment, a positive cash flow system, which means that your Mavro grows at 30%, everybody's happy. So now, let's say you were banking at a bank. What bank do you use? FNB. So let's say there was negative publicity about FNB, okay, that the CEO's corrupt, fraudulent, he's stolen all the money, okay? What are you going to do tomorrow? Huh? We're going to run and go take your money out, and so is the rest of South Africa. So if that happens, okay, what's going to happen to FNB? It's going to collapse, exactly, because FNB doesn't have your money. Are you aware of that? Do you know how fractional banking works? Fractional banking is basically how the banks steal your money and lend it out to other people without you really knowing about it. There's a law that states that every rand that you deposit, the bank can lend it out legally 17 times. So basically, with every rand that you deposit, you're creating debt in the country. So we're actually responsible for the poverty in the country. How sad is that? Not our fault. We didn't know. We don't know any better. So if that was the case in Triple M, okay, and everybody started to take their money out of Triple M, you can see here more money coming out of the system than going into the system, obviously Triple M would also collapse. But we have a safety net. It's called a pause mode. Okay, so in the event that there was a pause mode, okay, that there was more money coming out of the system than going into the system, the system pauses, which means that your Mavro is frozen. It's frozen, not lost. Okay, it's there to protect us as a community. It's there to protect us from our own stupidity and our own devices. Okay, that's how clever the system is. So guys, he's a genius. Okay, so there's zero growth that happens on your Mavro. Nothing happens. Okay, until us, the public, start introducing more people and telling more people to join and telling more people to put more money in the system. Okay, that's basically what the system is waiting for. You see, Triple M is basically self-policing. We're a community of people that just want to help each other, okay, and we self-policing. So we cause the growth, the success, or we cause the failure. Okay, so if there's panic in the community, Triple M will fail. If there is a good, healthy community, people that understand what's going on, the system will then remain healthy. Okay, so
A lot of people say to me, yeah, but can't it fail? I mean, aren't we going to run out of people? Well, let me ask you, the public, something. The population on Earth, is it increasing or decreasing? Increasing. So theoretically, then there are more people turning 18 than not turning 18. Yes or yes? Okay. So if there were more people turning 18 every day than the day before, will we run out of people? So then it's a fantasy. Okay, so then it can't fail. Then we can't run out of people. Does that make sense? Okay, cool. So when the system sees that there are more people providing help than getting help, the pause mode is lifted. Your Mavro starts to grow again at 30% per month. Happy days for everybody. We're printing money again. Are you excited yet? Still no pulse. Are we excited yet?
Yes.
Just checking. So ways to earn. There's six ways to earn with Triple M. The first way is when you provide help, okay, you get a one-time provide help bonus. Okay, this is a thank you from Sergey Mavrodi to say thank you for helping the community. Thank you for basically helping us crush the current financial system. Are any of you happy with the current financial system? Are any of you happy with the poverty in South Africa? Okay, because I'm pretty disturbed at the fact the way some people live in the squalor and in slums and they don't even have a house in these tin shacks. If you're not affected by that, then I don't know, then geez, you better check your heart, seriously. It really affects me. I mean, when you're at the robot, doesn't it affect you when you see these beggars? Okay, and they have to like fake the limp because that's all they can do. They just don't have a way out. It's not their fault. And everything else is in your local currency, ZAR. Your second way to earn is that when you pledge, you are able to do a video of happiness to say how delighted you are to help someone else. So when you give money, are you happy? Isn't that what the Bible says? Give money, donate money, okay? More you get, the more you give, the more you get. Does that make you happy? Yes? Or when you put your money in the hat, are you upset? Are you happy? Your pledge, your donation. So if you gave basically 1,000 rand, you'd get 10%, 100 rand, you'll get 50 rand for making the video. Isn't that exciting? So if you gave 1 million rand, you get 10,000 rand. That's free cash. I'll take it. Cool. So your third way to earn is your 30% growth on your Mavro. Your fourth way to earn, who came with a friend? Okay, couple of, please put your hands up, guys. Please participate. Thank you very much. Okay, so if you brought a friend, then you become the upline sponsor. Okay, if, let's say your friend provides help for 2,000 rand. You would then get 10% of their pledge, which is 200 Mavro, and your Mavro also grows at 30% per month. Okay, so some people say to me, I don't even have 100 rand to pledge. What am I supposed to do? Okay, no problem. Bring a friend to here next week. I'll get dehydrated on your behalf. You'll make all the money. Good deal.
Yes.
Exactly. So the fourth way to earn, or the fifth way, I'm lost already. There's so many ways to earn. Is basically a manager's bonus. Okay. This is when you make money off your entire organization. So you introduce Jack. Jack introduces Sam. Okay. Jack earns off Sam. You don't earn off Sam. You only earn off Sam if you become a manager. So these would be your manager bonuses here, okay, which is really exciting. So there's 10 levels, so you'd earn on 10 levels deep. On the 10th level, you'll earn 0.01%. After the 10th level, you'll earn from the 11th level to infinity, 0.1%, so it's infinite levels deep. This is an unlimited earnings potential. You decide how much you earn, okay, unlike in a job. Okay, well, you're capped. That's all you're going to ever. You with me, guys?
Yes.
So, this is the website. There's Sergey Mavrodi, the genius. And who was